Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hi, I'm Leri Hanson. I'm here to talk a little bit about Leo the Lion, the little Yag Terrier that I acquired from an old club member of mine. Leo is the only Yag that has a French ring brevet, and they did a heck of a job with him. I've had him for a few years now. He's about 9 years old, I'm guessing. He's an incredible little dog. I had begged for him for a while. I wanted him for my business, my bite prevention classes, and just to kind of give him a retirement home. He's had a rough life. He's had a few different homes. He's been through a few different trainers. The last guy who had him did a heck of a job getting the brevet on him. I really don't know much about the breed, other than they're incredible hunters. I will say this, I have met some other of his kind. None of them have compared to Leo. I really believe he is a special dog. Of all of the dogs that I have in my yard, he is the one that I am probably most respectful of, knowing that he has gone against beast and he has gone against man in a protection sport. And anywhere he goes, he is confident, he is ready, as if he owns the place. He just has so much attitude in such a little package. And I believe that is indicative of the breed in general. Yeah, Leo is an incredible little hunting dog. In fact, if you'll notice in some of the video, he has just one natural ear and one cropped ear. Story is, he lost one of the ears to a bobcat. I can't tell you what happened to the bobcat, but I know Leo lost an ear there. What's different than his past lives, I don't take him hunting, although he catches things around the yard, just to have freedom. He has freedom in the yard to run, to play, to sunbathe. He's not in a kennel or in a crate 24/7. And I think that in itself has made him a little bit clearer on clarity and calmness for this is your lifestyle now. And I'm trying to bring little pieces of that into the house as well. He did do a little go to ground, the American Working Terrier Association, and was a superstar. He was the only of his breed there. And some of the people with the other breeds were actually inquiring about him as a possible stud candidate just because he was such an incredible little hunter, knew exactly what to do. Go to ground is they dig holes in the ground and then they put these wooden tunnels in there. And depending on the level that you're at, some of the tunnels may be like a simple L, one turn, and at the end is a caged rat, where the dog cannot get to the rat, but he must indicate, and he must make some sort of scratching motion or barking to let you know that he found him. And they have to do that for a certain amount of time. And then they earn a go-to-ground title, so to speak. And it's our city way of hunting dogs, so to speak, letting them tap into their natural instinct. They allow any dog to enter as long as they can fit into the tunnel, because it's maybe 12 by 12. I'm not exactly sure of the measurements, but it's not real big. I have seen pit bulls do it. Some of the smaller pit bulls do it as well. When I got Leo, my friend didn't want me to take him because he was afraid it would ruin our friendship. And the reason he was concerned about that is because Leo's a hard keeper. He is a complete outside dog. He's a little bit dirty in the kennel. He's a fighter. He seems okay with females, but he told me never trust him because it doesn't take much to trigger him to turn on. And he said, treat him as if he were a game-bred pit bull, Larry. Do not trust him with other animals. Do not trust him to not sneak out of your yard. And it was love at first sight. The very first night I brought him home, I knew it was going to work. I knew it was going to work. I've never allowed him to be with other dogs. However, a couple of my females have gotten in the yard at the same time with him, and it's been okay. But as soon as we see it, we, of course, separate them very calmly. Leo also used to wear a bark collar regularly because he can be quite noisy. And over the time that I've had, in fact, the very first day I brought him home, my grandson Wyatt and I, we went shopping for him. We went to Petco and we got a big box full of toys. Wyatt picked out all these really great toys for Leo. And Leo was just in heaven. He had all these things. He didn't know what to do. He had so many toys. And some of his previous owners said, "You're going to ruin that dog." And I said, "I hope so, because he deserves a nice, cushy life." Since it's been a little bit colder here in Southern California, the last couple months or so, I've been bringing him in, crating him inside. And I have even ventured into taming the beast by sitting on the sofa, no leash or anything, but just telling him to stay here in my lap. And it's really hard for Leo to sit still for any amount of time. He's very busy. He's a busy body, but he's starting to like it. He's getting calmer and calmer all the time. And the older he gets, the more inside time I hope he's allowed to have. If I didn't have so many dogs, I'd try to make him a full-time house dog, but I'm afraid he would destroy my home. Leo now works for my business, which isn't super busy right now, but he and a couple of the other dogs, we load up, we go teach the bite prevention, and he has a really big role in the company in the sense that at the end of the class, everybody who wants to take a bite, it's Leo that we use. And although he gets tired, you know, he's a senior now, it's pretty incredible to watch the little guy fly across the room like a little Velcro to his little piece of sleeve, his burlap sleeve. He knows his home now. He could easily jump out of my yard. He doesn't try to. Even if there's a critter on the other side, he's responsible and he's respectful of the boundaries. He did fence fight one time with my bully, and he really kind of beat himself up. The bully didn't really have any marks. The bully was on the outside. Leo was on the inside. But Leo messed up his muzzle and a foot really bad. And so during that time, while he was healing, we had him in the house, and he seemed to enjoy that as well. He no longer wears the bark collar either. He doesn't need it. If we're going to play ball with the dogs in the backyard, we'll put a collar on him. In the morning when he goes out to get his yard time, and he's busy running his little circles and checking out all of the corners. And then I look out there and I see him sunbathing. And he just closes his eyes and he soaks up the sun. And to me, that is the most delightful picture, to see him actually calm and enjoying the moment rather than feeling the need to find something. I don't necessarily feel that the protection portion of work that Leo has had is an outlet to his hunting instinct. I think it's two completely different drives. And in fact, in order for him to go on to the next go-to-ground title, it'll be a more complicated search with several fake scents. There may be the smell of a rat there, but there will be no rat. He can't get hung up on that. And then once he does find the rat, I'll need to be able to recall him out of the ground. And I don't know if I can do that yet. However, I can recall him off of a decoy. So the mindset on an animal is very different than the mindset on a man. And Leo is, I wouldn't necessarily say he's social, but he's pretty neutral. If he comes up and rubs your legs, kind of like a cat, he likes you. He did that to Jedi here today. So that was kind of nice to see. But he is not a man stopper. If he wanted to be, if he had the right frame of mind to be aggressive, I think he could stop a person with his grip. He has a very big muzzle and he has a hard bite. Even though he only has two canines left, he can still bite. However, he is not of that nature. He really doesn't want to be in trouble. And I'll say this also, Zeke. I don't think I would ever want another one. Part of what made the relationship between Leo and my family work is the fact that he had so much prior training before he came to me. If I were to raise something up like that nowadays at my age, I don't want crazy anymore. And Leo's crazy. Leo, prior to coming to me, was pretty much just a strict working dog, strict hunting dog for some of his prior homes. And he was lucky enough to fall into the club members' hands that channeled some of that crazy drive that he had into an outlet, and that outlet was French ring training. Although he no longer is doing French ring, he still has plenty of go left, where we are preparing him for, hopefully, for PSA, at least do a PDC, which is the Protection Dog Certificate, and perhaps a PSA 1. The end of February, we do plan on taking him to an Iron Dog competition. We'll put him in the hard-hitting contest just for giggles, and we'll do the obedience and the temperament testing. He should pass all of that with flying colors. I wouldn't mind putting him in the confirmation ring. He is a little oversized. I have the show dog breeders tell me that all the time, but I think they're silly not to use him in their breeding program, because again, I've yet to see one like him. But I'm absolutely honored to own this little dog, to carry him his food every night and to pick up his poop. Leo's not going anywhere. Leo is in a full-time retirement home with a little bit of play on the side, just to keep him spry. And we just love him to pieces. He's an incredible little dog. Of all of the dogs I've had, and I've had some pretty darn good ones, I think I have the most respect for this little guy. He's a neat, neat dog.